Hi friends, welcome to Krishna's Tech Info. In this video we can see how to set up FTP server with VSFTPD on Ubuntu 18.04. FTP is a file transfer protocol. This is a standard protocol used to transfer files to and from the remote network. There are many open source FTP servers that are available for Linux. The most widely and popular FTP servers used are Pure FTPD, Pro FTPD and VSFTPD. In this tutorial, we can see how to set up FTP server with VSFTPD on Ubuntu 18.04. First, we can see how to install the VSFTPD. First, run the apt-get update command to update the packages. Now, we can install the VSFTPD. The command is apt-get install VSFTPD. Now, give enter. Now, it is downloading and installing the package. Now, the installation is completed. Now we can check the status of VSFTPD, systemctl, status, VSFTPD. Now the VSFTPD service is started. Now we can see how to configure the VSFTPD. Let's open the VSFTPD configuration file, vim/etc/vsftpd.conf. Now first we can see how to provide access only to the local users in the FTP server. Find the line with the anonymous enable. You can see the line anonymous_enable. The anonymous enable option should be given as no, which is disabled by default. And the local enable line should be yes to allow the local users to log in. Next we can see the enabling the uploads. For that, you need to search the line write enable. You can see the line write enable, which is disabled by default. Enable this line to upload the files to the server, and you have all the permissions to write and delete the files. This will provide the access to upload and delete the files to prevent the FTP users to access the any files outside of their home directories. You need to use the chroot jail, search chroot local user equal to yes. You can see the line. You need to enable this line to restrict the users to only to use the home directories for FTP access. Now go to the last line. Next we can see how to limit the user logins. To limit the user logins, you can add the user list enable option, userList_enable equal to s, and then user list file you need to mention userList_file is equal to /etc/vsftpd.user_list. And user list deny is equal to no. This will allow only the users which are present in this vsftpd.userlist file. Now save the file and exit. Next we can see how to add the FTP user. Add user FTP user. Now enter the password for the user. Next we can add the user to the allowed FTP user list. Echo FTP user pipe symbol /etc/vsftpd.user_list. Now the user is added to the vsftpd.user_list. Now we can create the FTP directory for the new user. Make directory /home FTP user /FTP_uploads. Now give enter. Now we can provide the permissions for the new FTP directory. Change mode 750/home FTP user /FTP_uploads. Then you need to provide the ownership for the directory FTP user /home /ftp/user/ftp/uploads, give enter. Now just now we have created a user with all the access. To disable the shell access and only use the user for SFTP purpose only, we need to create a new shell and set the shell to the new user. Now we can see how to create a FTP only shell. The echo -e quotes /bin/sh echo and add some nodes to it. Now give /bin/ftp only. Now give enter. Now the new shell is created. Next we can provide the required permissions to the shell. Change mode /x/bin/ftp only. Next we can add the new shell to the list of valid shells in etc shells file. echo /bin/ftp only pipe symbol /t-a/etc/shells. Now give enter. Now the FTP only shell is added. Now we need to change the user shell FTP only shell. For that you can use the user mode command. User mode, the username FTP user -s and /bin/ftp only. Now give enter. The shell will be changed. Now we can check the shell. Now we can see the shell is changed to /bin/ftp only. After configuring the SFTP server, restart the service. Now the SFTP service is restarted. Now we can check the SFTP access. Now provide the IP of the SFTP server, the remote host, and give the username. This is the SFTP user. Username is FTP user. Now give OK. Now enter the password. Now we can see the FTP user is successfully connected and now we are able to access the SFTP server. In this way you can set up the FTP server using the SFTPD in Ubuntu. Please post your suggestions in the comment box and subscribe to my channel for more technology videos, and please press the bell button to get instant notifications on my videos. Thank you for watching.